Hi, this is Peter Stanley. Welcome to my channel. Today I want to talk about drip irrigation and the components of a basic drip system. And then I want to give you some tips and strategy for designing your own. And lastly, I'll show my drip system as an example. At the very basic level, you need your water source, usually like a spigot or something. And then attached to that, optionally a timer, but I recommend it. This automates your system, which is the whole point. After that, you would have it's very important to have a backflow preventer or a vacuum breaker and a filter to keep stuff from getting into your drip lines, clogging them up. And after that, a pressure reducer, pressure regulator. This keeps from hammering your system. And then you would have a main line and usually some kind of connector to connect the two. I use the permalock fittings. Doesn't have to be, but and then your main line, typically it's like a half inch line, connect and then go out to your plants, and on the end would be a terminator. It could be like another permalock fitting. And to connect your main line to your plants, typically you would use quarter inch tubing. You could do one or two, and attached to the end of drip of the quarter inch line or drip emitters, and that's what waters your plant. So like if you had a container plant, this could stake down next to your plant and water it. Typically the emitters are different rates, different kinds really, but pressure sensitive emitters are typically like 1/2 gallon per hour, 1 gallon per hour, sometimes I think 2 gallon per hour. I use the 1/2 gallon per hour. You can use faster rate, you would just run them for less time. To connect to connect the half inch or quarter inch line, I use the barb connectors, and if you just wanted to do a single connector, you would just use like a straight. And this give you a kind of a zoomed in look of the main line. So you also would use a tool to punch a hole in the main line, and then your connector, one line end would go into the hole and the other line would attach to your quarter inch line. You could do, I use the T connectors, and that allows you to run two lines, and it kind of gives you a way to do pairs along your system. So with that, you would have, it kind of look like that. So the bottom would attach here. Each line, each end would connect to a quarter inch line. And what I do now is actually on the end, instead of one emitter, I do two. So I'd add additional T connector there, smaller drip quarter inch lines, and then two emitters. It gives a little better coverage and it adds some redundancy as well. So things to consider when you're designing your own or your growing space. The number of plants. Type of plants. Spacing, which is determined by the type. How much room to give between your plants and your budget. So taking that into consideration, I would first sketch out your system first on paper. And then price out all of your parts, like amount of half inch tubing, quarter inch tubing, connectors, emitters, etc. Then I would look for a comparable drip irrigation kit and to compare to see if you save money. You probably will save a lot of money doing that. And it'll give you everything you need to get started. I use Drip Depot, so I'm using them as an example. And I'm an affiliate of theirs, so if you purchase through my link, I'll earn some money. But I've been using them for a long time. They're really good. And they have a kits for any kind of drip system that you might need. So that's what I started with. What you would do is find a kit that approximates closely to what you're trying to do, and if maybe just a little more than what you need or just under, and if it's just under, you could add what you need to complete it. So now I'm going to take you outside and show you my drip system and how it works, and I'll show you how to install the emitters and the connectors to connect the quarter inch line to the half inch line. And also, before I do that, I want to show you, this is optional, but this I use one now, how a FERT injector works, because I'll show that as well. So this is your main line coming in. Your FERT injector, I use a diaphragm pump type, but similar, a lot of them are piston based, but so they're basically in line with your system. So you would come in here, come out there. And at the bottom, actual injector attaches to a feed line. that drops into your reservoir of concentrated nutrients. So it pulls that up, injects that into the stream, and then this goes out to your the rest of your drip system. That way it feeds your plants every time you water. If you don't use a fert injector, what I did before was mix slow release fertilizer into the potting mix. So every time I watered, I was feeding my plants that way. So let's go ahead, look at my system, and I'll show you how that looks.